Hello friends, today we'll study the concept of human development from the perspective of psychology. How that human has developed up to this stage and what are the stages that followed? What are the major stages in human development? What Indian literature, especially Bhagavad Gita, describes about human development? Who are the psychologists who studied the human development? And what does it means and what is the definition of human development? In this short video, we are going to study all these things. Let us start. Concept of human development. According to Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2, shloka 28, all bodies are latent in the beginning. They manifest in the middle. O Bharata, in the ends, they will become latent again. So why should you grieve about this? This shloka was uttered by Lord Krishna to the Arjuna, who sat down between the two armies that were ready to fight and said, I am not going to fight. To counsel that and to show the reality and to improve the cognitive process of that Arjuna, Lord Krishna spoke this shloka. This I have just picked up from the Bhagavad Gita. What does it mean? It means that life emerges. This, dear friends, remember it, that Lord Krishna is telling to Arjun. It means that life emerges from oblivion, manifests itself and finally dissolves into oblivion. Here word is manifest. Manifest itself means during a certain period the life shows itself. And it is the space, manifest itself is the space where development occurs in the city of nine gates. Again, Lord Krishna in chapter 5, shloka 13 describes human body as city of nine gates. The control and purification of mind is the fundamental in the process of development during the manifestation process. During that period, that individual manifests itself. The basic fundamental of development here, Lord Krishna emphasizes that the only one thing is control and purification of mind. If that has been achieved, development is beautiful and it has been achieved. Again, chapter 13, shloka 6. What Lord Krishna says, the field of activities. He clearly describes body as a field of activities. This means it is composed of five great elements. Number one, the ego. The second, intellect. The third, and revealed primordial matter, prakriti, the 11 senses, daksham. Daksham means 10 jama 1, 10 plus 1, 11. What are that 11 senses? 5 your knowledge senses, 5 working senses, and mind. This is your fourth. And the fifth great element is 5 objects of the senses. Okay? So, panch mahabhut, the 5 gross elements are earth, water, fire, air and space. 5 knowledge senses are ears, eyes, tongue, skin and nose. 5 working senses, voice, hands, legs, genitals and anus. And 11th it is mind. These are the elements, components of 5 great elements which are composed together to make a field of activities. We call it as a beautiful body. Again, chapter 13, shloka 7 says, desire and aversion, happiness and misery, the body, consciousness and the will, all these comprise the field and its modifications. Here field is, again it is a body. The body is the field of activities. It undergoes 6 transformations until death. These are itself a type of development. First is asti, coming into existence. That is coming from manifesting itself, coming from oblivion. Jayate, that is called birth. Vardhate, growth, increase in the size, in body organs as a whole. Then vipranamate, reproduction, production of progeny. Then apakshate, withering with age, your body, your organs starts withering, starts declining, and again the body dissolves into oblivion, and that process is vinashati, that is death. The most wonderful thing about this human body is it supports, it manifests itself in this body form is for supporting this soul in its quest for happiness. Dear friends, now let us go for psychologist who studied human development, Jean Piaget, cognitive development, Yuri Bronfenbrenner, contextual view of development, Leo Simeonovich Vygotsky, social development theory, Durganand Sinha, ecological model, Harry Frederick Harlow, effect of attachment on social and cognitive development, Eric Erickson, psychosocial development, and Lawrence Kohlberg, moral development. Here I want to make it very clear that this list is not exhaustive. Lots of other psychologists, sociologists, anthropologists, neuroscientists studied human development, which is out of scope to mention here. I have just mentioned 7. Now, what is the meaning of development? The gradual, qualitative as well as quantitative changes or acquiring new stages or lifespan by human being from conception to birth and to old age is the process of development. Two things I want to mention here is qualitative as well as quantitative. Qualitative means that cannot be measured into terms or quantities, whereas quantitative means it can be measured. We'll discuss in the further slides. Then acquiring new stages. New stages means changes in your body, and that occurs gradually. Next is the development is a structural, your body structural and functional flow through the cycle of life. It occurs throughout life cycle. The pattern of development is similar, but the manifestation of it is unique in each human being. Here it is that pattern of development across globe, across species, across human beings is similar, but the manifestation of it is unique in each human being. Now, what are the major developmental stages which are clearly shown here? Prenatal stage, 40 weeks to 9 months approximately, when individual is conceived and develops in mother's womb. Then comes infancy, up to 2 years, that means from birth to 2 years or 0 to 2 years. Then you come childhood, 3 to 11 years approximately. Adolescent, 12 to 17 years. Adulthood, 18 to 60 years. And my dear friends, old age, above 60 years. It is approximate, accepted by all. And see here, this picture clearly shows that that body again dissolves into oblivion. Now, this is all the major developmental stages. What is the definition of development? This picture clearly indicates development is a pattern of progressive, orderly and predictable changes that begin at conception and continue throughout life. This picture clearly depicts this. It involves both growth and decline. I want to make it very, very particular here is development involves both growth as well as decline. In which domains? Physical domain, psychological domain and social domains of human beings. This means that development includes both growth. Now you can see from infancy to childhood, it's a growth. Growth of your muscles, your cognitive activities, social interactions. Again, from this infancy to childhood, it's again growth. From that adulthood, adolescence or adulthood, and from here you can see there is a stark decline. Here also it is called as a development. And from there, old age, it is also a development. But in fact, it is not a growth, but it is development. It is a change. But physiological, psychological, it is decline. That also comes under the concept of development. What are the development changes which occurs in human being? Physical changes, muscular changes. Your muscles become strong. Your bone strength changes. Your physical, your height changes, your weight changes. These are all physical changes. Psychological changes in cognitive system. That is your thinking pattern change. Our problem solving capacity changes. Attention, we have more attention, less attention, all these activity changes. Perceptual process changing, we start perceiving things differently. This comes under cognitive domain. Social changes in interpersonal relations, social adaptations, social behavior, all these comes under the social changes. Here, development is not an isolated phenomena. It doesn't occur in isolation. It is the interplay of three important processes, that is biological process, cognitive process, and socio-emotional process. Now let us define one by one. What are biological process? The genes inherited from parents, from mother and from father, influence the development of height, weight, your brain development, heart, lungs, eyes, physiological features, all that develops according to some certain blueprint which we inherit from our parents comes under the biological processes. Second is cognitive. The changes in mental faculties, your cognitive domain, such as memory, your recognition, your attention, your perception, your understanding abstract ideas, means abstraction, understanding the abstraction. This all comes under the cognitive processes. And socio-emotional, the changes in the social interaction, emotional response, and in personality, etc. These are socio-emotional changes. For example, a child hugs his mother or father, that is socio-emotional response. It is a process. Or manifestation of sorrow by an adolescent on losing a competition, it is also socio-emotional process that comes with development. Now, there is a perspective on development that we call it as LSP or lifespan perspective. What that perspective describes this development? Development is a lifelong, but it contains both gain as well as losses. Development is multidirectional. Development is highly plastic. That is, within person, it is modifiable. When there's some development has taken place, it can be easily modified. Skills, for example, and abilities can be improved. Then development is influenced by the historical conditions. Dear friends, these lifespan perspective on development, I have taken from class 11 psychology book, NCRT book. You can refer that. They have beautifully explained this. For example, what is historical conditions? For example, the experiences of 20-year-olds who lived through the freedom struggle in India would be very different from the experience of 20-year-olds of today. Very beautifully defined that what is historical condition means. Then development is studied by psychology, anthropology, sociology, neuroscience, and other fields. This means development is not a unique phenomena of psychology. Other fields also study the human development in their own capacity, under their own scope. The individual responses are context dependent. What these contexts are? Individual response to a situation or any stimulus on the basis of inheritance. What inheritance is? What the gene he or she inherited from our parents, immediate environment, social setup, and cultural factors. All these are the context under which individual responds to a situation or a stimuli. Now, again, these terms I taken from NCERT 11 book. There are four major terms. Students get little bit mixed these terms. So let me clearly define what these terms means. What development means? Dear friends, a process by which an individual grows and changes throughout the life cycle is development. It contains both individual growth as well as changes. Here change means decline also. That comes under development. Now, second is growth. It refers to an increase in the size of the body parts or of an organized as a whole. It can be measured or quantified. Here, clear difference is growth is increase in the size of a body part or as a whole. As a whole, your body increases. That is only growth, which can be quantified or measured. Height, weight, your muscular strength, your chest, and these are comes under growth. Major difference is development is both as qualitative as well as quantitative, whereas growth is quantitative. The third is maturation. It refers to the changes that follow an orderly sequence, means a sequence which has been pre-decided. That sequence has been followed and are largely dictated by the genetic blueprint, which produces commonalities in our growth and development. Now, here, clear, what blueprint is? A genetic blueprint means what we inherited genes from our parents. That genetic blueprint decides and dictates the orderly sequence of maturation. Maturation contains both development as well as growth. And this maturation is the only point that produces commonalities, that it is common among all human beings. Maturation has to occur. And the last is evolution. Evolution refers to species-specific changes. Means what are the changes coming in specific species is evolution. For example, emergence of human beings from great apes about 40 million years ago. These were the evolution. These are the four terms: development, growth, maturation, and evolution. Dear friends, thank you for watching. Next lecture will be on principles of human development. Thanks. We'll meet you in the next presentation. Any doubt, any query you have, or any critical comments you have, you can email me on vermasujit@yahoo.com, and I will be happy to receive that. Till that time, thank you for watching this.